guys are going to be cultivated. And here comes the farmer. A typical Nigerian farmer comes to perform tillage and land preparation. The farmer comes, does his clearing, clears the farm area, gathering them. As you can see, he's gathering the leaves, the grasses. But what's he doing? What's he trying to do? He's cutting the trees. He's cutting the trees around his farmland. That's a bad idea. Wait a minute, what's he doing? He's gathering, trying to burn the farm. He's burning the plant material. Oh my God, this is not proper. This will kill the soil microorganisms and destroy the soil nutrients. He's done tillage and he goes on to plant his crop. The farmer goes on, as you can see, the farmer is planting. But who knows if he's planting at the recommended planting distance? Let's see what fate lies ahead of him. He probably does not even have an idea what it needs. He randomly put the seed into the soil. And he's done with his planting. And so here comes the progression of the seed. The seeds will sprout successfully into crop and has begun to flourish, manufacturing its food directly from sunlight in the presence of chlorophyll, a process called photosynthesis. Just as the farmer is happy and filled with positive expectation, wait a minute, here comes the farmer's nightmare. Erosion, flood water coming with high precision and attacks the farm. Oh my God, more trouble. Another enemy is coming. Oh, the wind. Oh, the wind that attacked the farm. The farmer must be furious when he meets it. You've got to be kidding me. Double trouble. The dangerous agents are back again. The water and the wind. They laid a siege and invaded the farm area. This time the topsoil is now depleted and degraded. What a terrible situation for the farmer. An awkward moment. And then comes him, the farmer. After multiple disasters, he must be devastated. This is an unexpected crisis. All his efforts, labor, money, all gone. Ladies and gentlemen, this farmer is troubled. He's sad. Is there a remedy? What's he thinking? What do I do? Yes, there's a remedy. He remembers a niece advertorial he had over the radio about the extension agents. He remembered them. He must seek the help of an extension agent. Off he goes to the ADP, where he can find one. It's very important that you don't just rush into the farm to produce your crops. You must test the soil and apply adequate management practices so you don't fall into danger. Now the farmer goes to the ADP and successfully secured the service of a soil extension agent. As you can see, the extension consultant carrying the soil log kit, a piece of equipment also called lab in the box. This implies that this box can provide all the solution a proper laboratory can provide. It tests, it analyzes right on the farm. You don't necessarily have to go to the lab. As you can see, the extension officer is analyzing the soil and is now advising the farmer. He starts by faulting the farmer's act of deforestation and burning his farmland and blaming him for cutting down the trees across the farm. He goes on to advise him that if you must cut down one tree, you have to plant two. Advising him to undergo good cultural practices like terrace fencing, applied organic material, and NPK fertilizer, recommending good planting distance and planting across roads. Here you can see the analysis has been done. And let's see if the farmer will this time listen to the advice given to him by the extension agent. He goes ahead to explain to him, you don't have to wait until there is several attacks on your farm before you visit, like this farmer did, and you have to do routine inspection because it's very good. It saves you time, saves you energy, saves you the risk of error, allows you to analyze your soil, the crops, right there in the field. Let's see if the farmer will yield to the advice of the extension agent. So here comes the farmer. The farmer is back. He's now repented. Extension agent to test your farm and get good variety of seed before going into business. You look for one when disaster strikes. The farmer now attempts to apply remedy. He starts with afforestation. He's making terrace fencing. He's replanting all the trees he cuts down. Let's see, he's making terraces and applying for the fence to protect the farm area against the precision of winds and water. And after that, the farmer comes with organic manure. This time, it's coming along organic manure and mineral fertilizer like the NPK. As the manure will help the soil to recover and increase the water holding capacity, the NPK fertilizers will provide soil with required minerals and nutrients in available forms where the plant will take them up. You can see the soil is regaining its original form, retaining its dark brown color once again. The farmer is now ready to plant. He has got the seeds, the good variety, and is now planting his field. Now he will plant at the recommended planting. He's doing the right thing. He's planting. The extension agents have advised him on what to do to make sure the farm area is not overcrowded. The farmer is done with planting. He has done a good job now. And here the seeds approaches. You can see the seeds are coming and flourishing. Like the other seeds that died earlier, manufacturing his food through photosynthesis. And then the farmer comes along with mulch. He mulch with organic materials such as dead plant materials to protect the soil and protect the plants and retain moisture. And at the end, return it to the soil to enrich it. He mulch the soil area to hold water and save it from the scorching of the sun. And when he's done with that, the farmer has done a good job. So now let's see if the farmer survived. Oh my God, is this for real? The agent of soil erosion are back again. They want to attack the farmer once more. Can they succeed? No, they can't succeed this time. They are held by the terrace fences. The trees won't let them. The wind is here, but they can't succeed. They are held by the mulching material. The farm is protected. The soil survives. The farm is intact. The nutrients are conserved. The farmer has survived. What about that? What about doing the right thing? What about good cultural practices? And here comes the farmer. He comes for his regular routine inspection. You know there was a heavy rain accompanied by wind, but his farm has survived. His consultation has paid him a fortune. He's now in business. Dear farmers, this is the way forward. Always, always consult the extension agent to prevent soil erosion and feed the nation. The Nigerian Institute of Soil Science has the mandate of regulating the practice of soil science and to promote sustainable soil management for maximum crop production. The food we eat, the water we drink, and the air we breathe all come from the soil. Soil is life. Soil is alive. Let's protect the soil. Neil Gray.